Yes, Lord. How many can say yes, Lord? How many can say yes, Lord? Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh. Because he first loved me. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me. Today, thank you, God, for loving me. Thank you for loving us, everyone in the building. Thank you. Thank you that you first loved us. Thank you that you first loved us. Thank you that you first, you did it first. Help us in this message today to see how much you love us. Help the one that feels rejected. Help the one today that is yet, God, afraid because of fear that you don't love them. Help the ones with broken hearts because of being abused in trying to get love. Help everyone in this room today to receive revelation of how much you love them. I promise you, when it's over, when it's done, and it's complete, I'll give you all praise, all credit, all glory, and all honor. In the matchless name of Jesus, I pray. Everyone said amen. 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 Come on, put your hands together. Give God some more praise. Hallelujah. Tears of joy. You may be seated. God's been so good. Let's see. Is Tevin here? Tevin ain't here? Okay. But anyway, come on, let's celebrate all of the Northridge 8th grade basketball team. State champions. Beat everybody, 28 and 0 for the school year. Some of y'all might have heard about your pastor. I went snap on Facebook because they didn't honor these young men. They didn't. The local newspapers didn't put them on the front page. What do they got to do? What do you got to accomplish to get on the front page of our local newspapers after you have beat everybody in the whole state and you don't marry the front? I'm mad. So I'm advocating for them. Amen. If they had stole something, they'd been on the front page. They'd have got the front page if they had been involved with a robbery or some kind of foolishness. But here you do the best job of any eighth graders in the whole state, and you don't get any recognition on the front page. They put them on the commercial news on the sports page, the other page. News Gazette didn't even put a picture up, just put a little caption over in the corner. So anyway, pray for me that I may ever go stronger in the Lord. I need some prayer when you mess with my babies. We got a lot of good students in District 118, and they don't get enough praise. Come on. The ones that cut up, they get a lot of attention, but a lot of them that are going to school every day and doing what they're supposed to do, don't nobody say nothing about them. But let them cross that line. Look at them with their little bad. Shut up. Anybody here for the first time visiting New Life? I'm probably going to run your way with snapping off, but come on back. I'll try to act better next week. Okay, everybody been here before? Good. Amen. I like it when people come back. Amen. A lot of people go to church one time because the congregation is so crazy. I was talking to somebody today, went to visit another church last week in another town, and nobody in the church spoke to them. What kind of church is that? You visited in the church and you won't speak to your visitors? You're stupid. I mean, they're stupid. Amen. So we want to always be nice to everybody. And don't be phonies, but be real. Amen. So again, today I'm, you know, want to minister to you, and I'll take a chance, so to speak, that I might make somebody mad, I might get somebody offended, but I still need to speak the truth. Anybody want the truth? If anybody should tell the truth, it ought to be the preacher. Y'all not be worried about no money. Y'all not be worried about the numbers. Y'all not be worried about being friendly and getting invited over to chicken dinner and all that stuff. Well, if I say that, they probably won't let me come over to eat no chicken. What's wrong with you now? You got too much chicken in you. So I'm going to preach again. We've been preaching in this vein for a couple of weeks, and we need to stay here. The Holy Spirit won't let me release you yet from the subject matter of you need to know how much God loves you. You need to know how much God loves you. We talked a little bit last week about how that many people are settling. They're settling. And the reason why people are settling for abuse and all kinds of negative relationships is because they don't know how much God loved them. But there's another part to the message today. That there's another part to the message today, and you got to get this today, because if you don't get this, then you are going to continue yourself in a vein where you will not really be able to help anybody else, because you can't help anybody else with love until you help yourself. It is absolutely impossible for you to love anybody else if you don't love you. And I already know it's going to be like, you know, a lot of thinking while I'm preaching, so I ain't looking for a lot of amens. I just want you to just suck it up. Just get it in your spirit. You cannot. It's impossible to love anybody unless you first love yourself. And this is another lie that we tell ourselves, that we love ourselves when we don't. See, you got to really try to make yourself believe you love yourself when you don't love yourself, because it hurts you too deeply to admit that you don't love yourself. So you play like you love yourself, and that's why you are always constantly looking for love. If you don't know you, my God, your own self-worth, if you don't know your own wonderfulness, your own greatness, then you're going to always depend on somebody else to give it to you. And that's dangerous. That's real dangerous, because hurting people hurt people. And somebody who can't even love themselves, how can they love you? Come on, y'all. There's nobody single in this room today ought to get married for love. No single person should go looking for love, because what will happen, you will now be dependent on somebody else's love, which means they can pull it when they get ready. They can flip the script anytime they get ready, because they know you don't love yourself, and the way you are desperately seeking their love, you can easily find yourself being manipulated. Single people should never get married to be complete. Single people ought to get married because they have love to give. Oh, I'm not bringing you into my space because I'm empty. I'm bringing you into my space because I got so much love. Boom, I can give you some. Boom, I'm already that in a bag of chips. I'm already confident. I'm already feeling good about me. I get up in the morning. I look in the mirror. I say, hello, wonderful. YouTheBomb.com. I already wake up going, I feel good. Like a new to the wood. But single people go into relationships broken. So there's now two broken people both looking for the same thing, and they'll never find it in a husband. They'll never find it in a wife. They got to only find it in themselves. You're quiet now. That is okay. God want to take you somewhere today. Where he want to take you is for you to have self-love. Self-love. See, when you don't love yourself, you compromise yourself. You lower your standards. You do stuff you don't want to do, but you're so desperate for love, you do it. What is the first thing little boys do and some little girls as soon as they start dating? If you love me, you'll do it. And that person who don't love themselves and don't know themselves yet will say, well, I've got to show them that I love them. But what about them loving you? Why would I do what I know I don't really want to do? Oh, I don't know myself. And so they threaten me with some other little boy or some other little girl that they know is hot to trot. And if you don't do it, I know you know so-and-so like me. And so when you go and let them trick you into doing what you didn't really want to do, then you find out after the fact, didn't change anything. A lot of girls running around with babies because they thought if they give him a baby. Look how quiet is getting in this room now. All of us adults that played that game just look straight ahead. The reason our kids can't get help is we won't tell them, it takes something to learn that love don't love nobody. It takes some. I can hear Felipe from the Spinners. I can hear him. It takes some. But we get in the church and we play like we never been the fool. So now our kids can't get no help. Because they're dealing with the same insecurity that you were dealing with. And you need to tell them, baby, that's why I'm saved. Because I was a fool once too. But I decided that God was my everything. So mama, daddy, why don't y'all have nobody? Well, because I'm waiting on somebody that is not going to make a fool out of me again. When you don't understand that God already loved you, I got to get this in. See, God don't wait for you to audition. You don't have to have any talents or gifts. You don't have to have any money. You don't have to have any education. You don't have to have a Cadillac. You don't have to have a house on the hill. God chooses us when we have nothing. God's not waiting on you to come to a place where the world now says you are worthy. One of the worst things they got in this world is what they call first class, second class, middle class, and all the other class. Ain't no such thing in God. Ain't no such thing in God. Don't you let nobody ever try to make you feel like you are not as good as they are because of something they have that you don't have. Well, take their things and see what they do. Because their things is what prop up their ego. But how many folks can love themselves and you ain't got nothing in the physical that says you are great because you know already God loved me just like God ain't waiting for me to get this place of success to say that I am great. Read your Bible. Read it. It says, and you are fearfully and wonderfully made. He said, when I built you, I made you like me. I made you in my image and in my likeness. He didn't say anything about once you get these certain levels of success, then I'll love you. But God said, when I built you just like me. I love this, y'all. I love this. Do you know you don't have to be a certain height for God to love you? You got people with stilts on. They call them high heels, but they're 7 feet tall, but they really 4 feet tall because they say, if I get up high enough, then somebody will recognize me and love me. Then you got the person that's 6'10", who's always stooping down. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Why? Because he or she don't like their height. But God said, I built you with the height I gave you. And I want you to know that I love you with your short self, with your tall self, with your black self, with your white self, with your nose wide, with your feet flat. Come on here. Most of us got a self-hate. And the reason why we hate ourselves is because we let people validate us. We keep letting humans tell us if that is good enough for them. I may not ever be good enough for you, but I'm good enough for God right now. That's why I sing more than I should, because I don't care. I can't reach Sister Miller's perfect pitch. I cannot be like Minister Greg Philpott and other men that sing good. I sing TM style. See, I was working that last song real easy. I was trying to keep it. I was like, let's see. Oh, how see that thing right there was working real good for me. Boy, but if I threw it up, I wouldn't have been able to get it. It would have came cracking, popping, and falling down. But tell your neighbor, I ain't got to sing good for God to love me. I don't have to play one instrument for God to love me. Come on! Tell your neighbor, I ain't got to be the pastor for God to love me. I ain't got to be the first lady for God to love me. I ain't got to be the head person in the choir. I ain't got to be the head deacon this and the head person that. I ain't got to have a PhD. I ain't got to live across the lake. I ain't got to go all over the world and say I'm well traveled. I can be right in Carver Park, Fair Oaks, Green Meadows, Vermillion Gardens, and say I know that the Lord loved me. There's no auditioning for God's love. People make you audition. Get in all these little clicky-clicky clubs and they always got some kind of thing you got to pass first. Well, you got to do this right here. You got to do that right there. If you don't do that right there, then you can't be in our little clicky-clicky club. And then you at home all depressed. They wouldn't let me in. And I did everything they said. I did everything he said, and he still didn't marry me. I did everything to be the best wife I could be, and he still don't love me. I brought all my money home. I didn't cheat on her, and she still don't love me. I took care of the kids. I did everything that was required of me as a wife or a husband, and they still don't want me. You live your whole life auditioning, you'll never be happy. Because you ever understand that when you reach a certain level, people always move the line. Oh, you done that? Now let me see if you can do this. Oh, you done that? Now let me see if you can do, you know what? You know what? Skip you. And your mother-in-law. Self-love, because we're going to read the scripture. Let's get some scripture. I went along. Nope. You must didn't get my text. Okay. I want Mark 12, and 30 and 31, Mark 12. Because I gave them this on Friday, but I text back. So I'm sorry, Deke, I didn't check, double check what you see if you got this other text. But I need Mark 12, 30. Y'all read it the last couple of weeks. We're going to read it again. Mark 12 and 30 and 31. Some of you need to remember to bring your own Bibles. Don't get so comfortable with these big screens. Amen. You don't know when technology ain't going to support it. Amen. You need to read your own Bible. We need not be ashamed. We still need to bring our Bibles to church. Amen. Don't let your neighbors make you feel bad because they say, you going to church? Yes, I'm going. Got my Bible on my side. I got my weapon. Mark 12 and 30. Come on, it says, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. Second one, this is the one we're going to really focus our attention on today. 31. And the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. Stay right there, Deke. If you don't love yourself, how could you love your neighbor? Tell me, how could you be a good husband if you don't love yourself? How could you be a good wife if you don't love yourself? And what's wrong is we won't admit that the love problem is not with other folks, but the love problem is with us. So you can't be a great person to nobody else until you first understand, how do you love you? So you can't love anybody else until you love yourself. It's impossible. You can forget it. Because when you don't love yourself, that makes you jealous. Because that means when you see other people doing something, you can't celebrate them. How can I celebrate you when I don't even think that I'm good enough? So why should I be happy about your car or your house or your husband or your family or your ministry or whatever you're doing if I myself don't love myself? I'm not going to be able to give you what I ain't got. It's simple. You cannot give what you don't have. So it says love your neighbor as you love yourself. So if I don't love me, I'm going to show you that I don't love me when I beat you. See, the only way I can beat you is proof that I don't love myself, because I'm not beating me. But I'm beating me when I'm beating you. When I call you every name in the book, I'm telling you I don't love myself. Because see, if I love myself, I never cuss myself. But since I don't love me, then I'm going to show you that I don't love me by the way I cuss you, the way I degrade you, the way I manipulate. Because if I love myself, I never have to use witchcraft to get you to do anything. But when I don't love myself, I feel like I have no other choice but to do something wicked to get my way. Because I'm so desperate for love, because I don't know love for myself. And so I have to use all kind of tricks and gimmicks to get you. And it really is not really getting you, but it's getting me. People really feel good when a man or a woman tell them, or anybody, I love you. I mean, it's an alien. It's got 3 miles. I love you. No disrespect, but I mean, you know, people are desperate for love. They just let anybody be their husband or wife or their boyfriend or girlfriend. Y'all quiet now. If you don't love yourself, you'll take love from anywhere. When you don't love yourself, you'll take love from anywhere you can get it. Because you don't love yourself, so you'll say, anybody tell me they love me, then you'll go bear them down. These little kids, they say some of them don't have the right kind of relationship with their parents. And then because they don't have the right relationship with their parents and they haven't been taught about love, then that's why they're in the gangs. Because they say, I want somebody to love me, and my mom and my daddy don't love me. And it's because they haven't learned how to love themselves. I ask the children all around when I talk to them, I say, tell me this, who are you? 99% cannot answer the question. And because they don't know who they are, that's why they're always acting out who they think might accept them by living a certain way and acting a certain way and dressing a certain way. Because they haven't discovered themselves. So they want to fit in. They say, I got to fit in somewhere. So this is what they're doing. They're drinking tonight. I'm drinking. I know what my mama said, my daddy said. I know what my wife said, my husband said. But I'm going to get with this person because I don't love myself and I don't know what love is. And so I'm trying to find it. Tell your neighbor, it's not outside, it's inside. It's inside. What you're looking for is inside. It's already been given you. You don't believe it. God love you. God love you. Why does he love you? Because you all that in a bag of chips. But society said you don't have a degree. You ain't that. But God said you don't need a degree for me to love you. There's nothing wrong with getting a degree, but don't wait to get a degree because some people get a lot of degrees and they still getting high and drunk. They got a PhD and they still snorting coke. They got $1 million and they snorting coke. You got some of the most beautiful women in the world getting divorced. Why? Because the man that got with him didn't love himself. He didn't know what he had. Stupid. I ain't stupid. Almost got in a fight in my dream last night. I did, Deacon Lyle. I was in church, and a man put his arm around Sister Miller in my dream right before I woke up. And I took his arm off of Sister Miller, and I put my arm around, and I drew her to me. Then I woke up. I said, what was that all about? Even in my dreams, I'm trying to let it be known. Don't even try it, Bubba. 911 to the church. But if you don't love yourself, you don't even know when God bless you. I said, when you don't love yourself, you don't even know when God has already blessed you, because you don't feel love for your own self. You reject love when it comes. You can't love nobody till you love yourself. Let's get some scriptures. I'm going to let you go. Come on, this is a little bit of reading. Can y'all read? Come on, let's read together a little bit today. Beloved, let us love one another, for God is love. For love is of God. Y'all can read, I can't, but y'all help me. And everyone that loveth is born of God and what? Knoweth God. If you love, then that's proof that you have met God. You cannot still be a liar and a cheater and Mr. Meany and Mrs. Meany and talking about you met God, because God is love. God is love. And if you and I have had a relationship encounter with God, then we are now love, because God is love. Amen. Come on, let's read. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. Is that clear? In this was manifest the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. Herein is love, not that we loved God, but that what? He loved us and sent his Son to be, for our sins. Do y'all hear? We sung the little song, I love the Lord because he first loved me. Oh, how I love Jesus, because God is love, right? Come on, y'all in this room. How many know we need to not wait for people to love us, but if we are love, we'll love them? Because that's what God did. God didn't wait for people to get good to love them, because if you have the love of God in you, you're going to love people, period. You don't care what they're doing. You love them. You want the best for them. But most of us that are in religion, we're waiting for people to qualify. Everybody in this room got to be real careful about telling your personal business. Because if you tell your personal business to church folks, they won't sit with you next Sunday. You been to jail. You be fighting? You been fighting? You used to steal stuff? Where my purse? You can't be honest in church, because in church, most people are judging you based on what God has done for you. And okay, let's get it 100%. God ain't through with you yet, but people say, I'm waiting for God to get through with you before I love you. So you better not tell folks I'm still struggling with the cigarette. Don't tell them you're struggling still with, you know, you got this man, you got this woman, you ain't married. Don't you tell them that. Not these church folks. What? Because I love you, sister. I'm going to tell you, I'm going to leave you alone. till you get yourself together. Instead of saying, sister, I understand. I love you. I love you. I want the best for you. I'm going to pray what you want me to pray with you. Instead of now, I'm done with you. Look how quiet it's getting in this room. We scared to be transparent in church because church folks don't love like God loves. Church folks love the way the world loves. I got some Bible coming up if I don't run out of time. And I'm telling you, God is looking for us to do what he has done, and he loved the world. He loved the world. Hello? The world. That means every homosexual, he loved them. Every liar, he loved them. Every thief, he loved them. But if you don't love yourself, you can't give no love away. But because God is love, we're supposed to be loved, and we should not be intimidated by people who have not yet matured to love themselves yet. Beloved, if God so love us, God love us, we ought also to love what? And I know we like to say it, but it's a lie. You don't love folks. You like to say it. I love everybody, but I don't like folks. You lying. Love is the highest level. If you love, then you're like. If you love, you're like. Don't tell me you love, then you don't like. That's the devil talking. I love everybody, but I don't like a lot of folks. You don't love nobody. You're lying. No man has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God dwelleth in us, and his love is perfected in us. Come on, y'all, say, God, I thank you. You ain't done with me. Come on, somebody say, God's still working on perfecting me. God is still perfecting me. But while God is perfecting me, he's still loving me. God ain't waiting for me to get perfected and then say he'll love me. But while I'm falling, God is loving me. While I'm still in my mess, God is still loving me. While I'm still struggling, God say, I ain't done with you, son. Church folks will be done with you. When you don't love yourself, you need somebody else to put down. When you don't love yourself, you need to find fault in other people so I can feel better about myself. Because, see, I don't love myself, and so I can feel better about myself because I'm now saying she done more than what I done, so I must be better than she. None of us is nothing. In the perfect, we're not perfected, none of us. But all of us are still on that road. We're still trying to get there. Come on here. Hereby know we that we dwell in him and that he in us because he has given us of his spirit. The Holy Ghost is more than chills. And it's more than that. It's more than huckabucka, huckabucka, huckabucka. It's more than that. It's more than rolling around on the floor spitting. It's more than that. You got a ghost. I don't know what kind you got, though. But the Holy Ghost is love. I said the Holy Ghost is love. If I come in your space, I should know you got the Holy Ghost by your spirit. Insecure people don't speak to other folks. People that are they're not sure of themselves, they can't be happy about it. Some of y'all see some of these sisters walking in with some pretty dresses on, and you never compliment her. Because you are absolutely not sure about your own self. That brother's cleaner than the board of health, and you never compliment him. You always make sure you go around him. You admire his nice suit. You just, man, I ain't thinking about him. Because you yourself don't understand that God already loved you with your flip-flops on. You can flip-flop right up by somebody with a brand new dress on and say, hey, how you doing, girl? Brother, how you doing? You ain't got on nothing but your Payless specials, and you just as confident. That brother got out of a Bentley, and you got off the bus, and you can say, hey, what's up, man? How you doing, my brother? All this flipping. You got out of the Bentley, he got out of the bus, and you going, hey, what's up, man? How many know when the folks get the stuff, they act like all of a sudden, now I can't speak to you. You work on a job and somebody got a starting position with you and then they get 10 cents more on the hour. The next day, they don't even speak to you. Y'all better go to work. Just flip the whole script. Rode the bus together every day. Now they bought a hoopty and now they can't talk to you. Boom. Boom. But I'm better than you. I ain't on the bus no more. No, your worth is not in the material things you have. Your worth is not in your degree. Your worth is not less because you don't live out on Snob Hill. You're just as righteous as anybody. Come on, we got to move. And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent to be the Savior of the world. Somebody say everybody. He came to save everybody. Come on, let's shout in this place. Hallelujah! 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 God love me. I'm in the world. God love me. He's inclusive in his love. He's not exclusive. He's not discriminating. He loves everybody. He said there was not one righteous. No, not one. So he came for all of us. Amen. Wait a minute. I didn't even get you up. Where's you at, Marsha? This is regular church. This is TM kind of church. You had an announcement about marriage classes on this Wednesday. It's going to be 3 weeks, and it starts at 7 p.m., prayers from 6 to 7. It's going to be off the chain. The title of it, Light Bank. Wait a minute, say it again. Light Bank and Shake. And you got to come get the detail. I got a board meeting. Maybe I can call in. No. This is for everybody. This is for everybody. It's geared toward, things that are really, really relatable to married folks. But if you're single, you need to know how to be married. I said if you're single, you need to want to know how to be married. You don't get married and try to figure out after you get married. You need to find out what it takes to be married. A lot of married folks is just now trying to find out after the fact. That's why it's a mess. People walking around with guns talking about, come on in the room, come on in. But I thought you said you love me. I did that last year, but this year. Amen. So this Wednesday, back to the message, 7 p.m. Everybody, unless you're scared of hearing something that's going to help your marriage. Me and Sister Miller did some marriage classes and people started getting divorced. Yeah, they got mad. You'll be telling us what to do in our marriage. I thought you wanted to have a good marriage. I do, but you can't tell me how to have it. Matter of fact, watch this. I'm going to get divorced now. Stupid. Come to the marriage class. It's going to bless you. Okay. Whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him and he in God. And we have known and believed the love that God has to us. God is what? Is he wearing us out with this? If we are God's children, we should be love, right? Everybody that meets us and gets to know us, they should know us from a love position. We should never be known as the liar and the thief and the hater and the deceiver. We should be known that that person exemplifies the love of God. And he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God and God in him. Come on. Herein is our love made perfect, that we what? May have boldness in the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in the world. Somebody say, I ain't got to be afraid of judgment day. I ain't got to be afraid of judgment day. If I'm loving, doing what God's telling me to do while I'm in the earth, judgment day ain't going to scare me. But judgment day is going to be one of the dreaded days of your existence if you're not living right. If you're not operating in love, you're just living ungodly, you're going to be afraid of judgment day. But judgment day should not be something you are dreading or fearful of if you operate in love. Herein is our love made perfect, but we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is what? No fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear has torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. Somebody said, do the right thing. You want to be afraid. It's only when you're doing wrong that you have fear. But if you do what's right, you ain't got nothing to worry about. That's your car with your insurance, with your title on it, driving the right speed limit. Why are you scared of the police? You scared of the police when it ain't your car and you ain't got no insurance and you ain't got no tag on it and you're driving 70 into 30. That's when you're scared. So if you do the right thing, you ain't got nothing to worry about. Anxiety and fear comes from disobedience. Treat your wife right, treat your husband right, you ain't got nothing to worry about. As long as you don't act a purity fool and you wonder why they don't want to be with you no more. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out all fear. And because fear has torment, he that feareth is not made perfect in love. What? We love him because he first loved us. Amen. Come on. If a man say, I love God and hated his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother whom he has seen, how can he love God whom he has not seen? Tell your neighbor, quit playing. Talking about you love God. You looking at folks every day you hate. Don't like people because they got different skin or different backgrounds and whatever. You really haven't met God. But you have, because God is sometimes brown. And sometimes he's white. And sometimes he's beige. And oh my God, sometimes he is absolutely cray-cray. That's still your brother. I don't care. Everybody in this room got family members who try to hide them. We don't ever bring them out. You go to their house, they say, I thought you had one more brother. That's all right. What's that? Don't go in that room right there. And we try to decide who we're going to love. And God said, everything down here is a reflection of me. You don't like it. You don't like it. But God is love, right? Keep on the top of the message. The top of the message is God do not wait for you to audition. So God takes you just like you are. Aren't you glad? I'm glad. God took me. Just like I was, he took me. I'm so glad God didn't wait for me to get to church before he would take me. Because most churches still won't take me. Most churches still say, TM, you can't come up in here. I like to preach, not in here. You have not been qualified to preach in our church. Amen. Whole lot of places, they still won't let me go. And God said, I love you just like you are. Can I get a witness? And this commandment have we from him, that he who loved God love his brother also. Okay, let's get it. 1 Corinthians 13. We got to get ready to go. This is just a breakdown. Everybody that's familiar with your Bibles, you know about this. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity. Somebody say charity is love. So that means you can speak in tongues and you speak in King's English, but you meaner than a junkyard dog. All of them tongues and all of that good diction that you know, it will not help you at all. God is not impressed because you speak in tongues. He wants to know, will you love folks with your tongue talking self? You got the largest vocabulary of anybody in the church, but you are full of the demon. You don't like people. Though I speak with tongues of men and of angels and I have not charity, I am become as sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. Somebody say no sense to it. It's a waste. It's making noise. And though I have what? The gift of prophecy, and I understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, I have not charity, I am nothing. You mean to tell me a prophet and an apostle and my God, word of knowledge, you got all of that? And God said, if you don't have love, you are nothing. Can y'all see that in the church? You got a lot of people who think they deep because they have some kind of spiritual gift, but they won't even speak to you after service. You go to work with them and they won't even speak to you on the job. You see them in the grocery store, they won't even speak to you. But they want to get them prophet. I will tell you what thus say. You ain't going to tell me nothing. Get away from me with your mean self. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned and have not charity, it profit me nothing. Somebody said, quit setting yourself on fire. It ain't going to do you no good. Show everybody I'm so deep. Watch this. You're still going to hell hot already before you get there. You're just going to be burdened twice. Amen. Look at what it says. Charity suffered long. Somebody said, quit justifying being short with people. Quit justifying. Okay, I'm telling you, I'm not taking another thing. If you got the Spirit of God in you, you will listen to the same story over and over and over again. You keep dealing with people. You keep working with people. But if you're so deep, you can't even tolerate another moment of somebody, you need to get delivered from yourself. Charity suffers long. It is kind. Someone says kind. When do you have a right to bless anybody out? When you feel like you so all that I just got to get her toe? God quieted it. I didn't know we had that many blessing out people in here. Charity, envy is not saying you never quit being jealous of folks. If you love yourself, you won't be jealous of nobody. If you really understand that God loves you, you don't have to have what they have, and you don't have to do what they do. You don't have to look like her or look like him. You don't have to have that car, that house, or that degree. God loves you just like you are. Envy if not charity, vaunteth not itself, is not what? Whew. Man. Some of the people that just think they all that in a bag of chips, they always going to tell you how great they are. But they don't ever celebrate nobody else. Do not behave itself unseemly. Come on, y'all. If you got the love of God, you would not be over there and save a lot fighting. You would not be out there in the middle of the parking lot acting a fool. Amen. You won't be involved with the crazy if you know the love of God is in you. Somebody say, hold your peace. God will fight your battles. You're so quick to jump up and bless folks out. You need to sit down and shut up. Seeketh not her own, it is not easily provoked. Think of no evil. She had no business saying what she said. No, you had no business responding to what she said. Not easily provoked. Y'all don't care what you say about me. I know who I am. You can say whatever you want to say. You have to figure out who I am. I already know who I am. So you call me some name that I'm not. I'm not going to get up and try to defend what you said. I'm looking at you because you're stupid. You don't even know who I am. I don't have to get in no fight with you. I don't have to get in no cussing match with you. I don't have to get in no tweeter match with you. Tweeter, what is it? Yeah. Get on Facebook and tell everybody how you feel about certain people. Let the whole world know you have been taken off your square. Seeketh not her own is not easily provoked. And what? Somebody said, think of no evil. Come on, we got to go. Rejoice is not in iniquity, but rejoice is in the truth. Come on. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, and doeth all things. That's what love do. Somebody said, hang in there. Just keep on hanging in there. Just keep on believing everything going to be all right. Charity never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child, but when I became a man, I put away childish things. Somebody said you have to know that love means you are not involved with the cray-cray no more. You're not always spatting and upset and mad and cutting up and falling out and acting crazy because you matured. You're not a child anymore. We got some little one-year-olds, two-year-olds around here. They got it right. That's what they do. They one and two. But they walk in here 15 with a pamper on, we got to give them some help. Walking in 15 with a pacifier and a pamper, that one needs some help. Get some help for that one right there. But now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face, now I know in part, but then shall I know even as also I am known. Come on, read the last one, everybody. Come on, y'all. Stand on your feet. Give me the last one, D. I'm going to make them stand with me while we read it. For if we love them, what? If we love them which love you, what thank have ye? For sinners also love those that love them. You're not mature if you can only love people that love you back. Because if you already got self-love, you don't care about them folks not loving you. I always love me. So I ain't into no conflict with anybody because I'm already confident in who God says I am. And if you do good to them which do good to you, what thank have ye? For sinners also do even the same. So quit waiting to just figure out who you can help so you can get a payment back. Help somebody that you know ain't got nothing to give back. Somebody said do right just because it's right to do right. And if ye lend to them of whom ye hope to receive, what thank have ye? For sinners also lend to sinners to receive as much again. But love ye who? Love who? That's a misprint in the Bible. Love who? That woman has just talked about me. That man just talked about me. Somebody just did me wrong. Love them. That's in the Bible. And do good and lend, hoping for nothing again, and your reward shall be great, and ye shall be the children of the highest, for he is kind unto the unthankful and unto the evil. Be ye therefore merciful as your Father also is merciful. Judge not and ye shall not be judged. Condemn not and ye shall not be condemned. Forgive and ye shall be forgiven. Give what? And it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men give unto your bosom. For with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. And I submit to you, this scripture ain't got nothing to do with just giving money. Did y'all see them verses we just got through reading? It was dealing with loving folks who are hard to love. It was showing us how that God wants us to give folks what they don't have a right to. And in so doing that, God said, I'm going to give that back to you. Good measure and pressed down and shaken together. Hallelujah. Come on, bow your heads. Don't leave the building unless you just got to go. Got to go to work at 1 o'clock. You ain't got to go to 2. Hang out with us for a minute. Burn the roast up next week, adjust it different. I'm just kidding about burning roast. I know that ain't happening. When you get the Red Lobster, they're going to still have some more shrimpies. Chinese place, they're going to still chop it up for you. Give me something.